It is time to put the waffle iron languishing in the back of your cabinet to good use. Hi and salam alaikum, this is Rakia from Rakia's Kitchen. If you are here for the first time, please do subscribe and hit the bell button to have all the notifications from our channel. This airy, delicate and crisp edges waffles are so fabulous, yet so simple to throw together. They are destined to become part of your weekend breakfast routine. So let's get started, guys, and let's make this incredibly delicious and fluffy waffles. For the ingredients, I'm gonna leave everything in the description box. You can check it out later, guys. We need a butter and salted butter, of course. We need all-purpose flour, egg, sugar. This is roasted milk powder, is optional, is I added to the recipe. Baking powder, salt, vanilla and milk, full cream milk. So as you can see, guys, there is not much of ingredients in these waffles, and the best waffles is always with the good butter. So for me, I like always to prepare the dry ingredient separately. That means I will mix the milk, baking powder, salt and flour together, except sugar. I will keep it aside. So I mix all these dry ingredients very well, then I put it aside. In a Pyrex or in a bowl, I will pour the sugar, then the egg, then I will whisk everything together until I have that nice smoothy creamy mix. So here I use the electric mixer. You can use just the hand mixer, is up to you guys. Then I melt my butter, the butter I have, of course, is unsalted butter, and I add it with the vanilla liquid or vanilla powder, if with whatever you have. Then I add the milk and I mix everything until I have liquidy creamy mix. After that, I took the hand whisk, then I start adding the dry ingredient and mixing everything together until I have nice butter. It's really fluffy, you will feel it. It's light and fluffy, you can like feel your butter during while you are mixing it. It's really good. And I'm sorry about my voice, I'm a little bit feeling not well. So I hope this will go away soon. Here we preheat our waffle maker or iron waffles. So I drizzle a little bit of oil, then I pour the waffle batter, then I start cooking it. So during you cooking your waffles, you will see the smoke is coming out of the edges of your machine. And when that smoke stops, just count 3 to 5 minutes, then your waffle will be ready. So what I do, I freeze leftover if you have any in a Ziploc bag, and serve them during the week. You can pop them in the toaster to reheat. Use a light setting, of course, for your toaster, and they come out nearly as well as freshly made, maybe even slightly crunchier. So you know what I mean. So here I always, when I want to freeze it, I don't cook it really fully. I keep a little bit like not that well done, but the ones I like to serve in the time, I cook it really fully, like the one you are seeing now in the video. So I'll keep cooking the batters until I finish the all batter I have, and just full your, like, pour your mix from the edges first, then in the middle. That's what I found is easy, and you make it nice and without any missing in the square, like almost the good square, and you can see the smoke is a lot when you when the waffle iron is really hot. So always I like to serve my waffle with extra fun for my kids, especially for my little one Noah. He liked the fireworks, so I do add like some fireworks wherever I serve waffles or pancake or any. So I did like this for him, and just decorate it with some raspberry and strawberries and cream, of course just whipped cream, and chocolate ganache. And the decoration is up to you guys. It's just open your mind and whatever you like and however you want to serve it, just serve it. And you can see my little one, he cannot wait. He want to eat as quickly as he could. And he liked the chocolate popping on the side. And this was the video for today. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up and do share it with your friend and your family. And I'm gonna say, fi aminillah, Allah hafiz.